Hello everyone, and welcome back at today's analysis. Now, for the next episode, I'm going to analyze none other than Peter Parker, also known as Spider-Man, the titular main protagonist of Sam Raimi's film franchise with the same name, and a minor character in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. By far the most iconic interpretation of the character in the cinematic history, Billy McGeary has done a fantastic job in portraying the character in my opinion, and in this episode I'm going to analyze all the information given about him from Spider-Man 1, 2 and 3, and from the 2021 MCU film, Spider-Man No Way Home, to better understand this version of Peter Parker, and his journey from an average teenager to the iconic hero he has ultimately become. Now without further ado, let's dive in. Peter Parker was born in New York in 1983. While from a young age, he has officially lost his parents, and he was raised by his aunt and uncle, May and Ben Parker. He had a pretty normal childhood, and his teenage years were pretty normal. He was best friends with Harry Osborn, the son of the famous CEO and billionaire Norman Osborn, and as well as with Mary Jane Watson, an average girl with family problems, who he had a crush on. Everything seems to be normal, but in one fateful day in 2002, when he was into a visit with his class in Oscorp, a spider managed to bite him and officially allowed him to gain spider-like abilities, enabling him to project web from his hands, to climb upon the buildings, and even to have the strength, durability and agility of a spider. And thus, the iconic superhero that we all know as Spider-Man was officially born. However, this gift did not come without sacrifices, as his uncle, Ben Parker, was killed by a thief who Peter led to escape, which caused immense remorse in the boy as he tracked down the thief and managed to bring him to justice. And his first such nemesis has officially risen, the Green Goblin, which will later reveal to be the Norman Osborn, the father of Harry Osborn, his best friend, who ultimately tried to persuade Spider-Man more than once to join him, so they both together can take over New York City. Of course, Peter refused to do so, and instead chooses to confront Norman, which ultimately led to his untimely death, and with Harry becoming vengeful upon Spider-Man, desiring to kill him. As Peter finished high school, he took a job as a photographer at a news channel, and continued his own personal career as Spider-Man for years to come. By 2004, however, things began to go downhill, at least temporarily for him, as Mary J. Watson began to fall in love and marries with another man. Harry hates Peter for the fact that he seemingly believes that he protects Spider-Man, given the fact that he took numerous photos of him, unaware that they are both the same person. And a new supervillain arrived in town, Dr. Octopus, formerly known as Dr. Octavius, who went crazy after his experiment went wrong and his wife died, who tried to recreate his own experiment by creating a miniature sun that would have deliberately absorbed New York into itself. Thankfully, Spider-Man managed to redeem Otto, and in this one sacrificed himself to defeat his own invention. And upon Mary Jane and later Harry finding out the truth about his identity, MJ ultimately fell in love with Peter. But Harry became determined to kill Peter in order to avenge his father's death. As for now, by 2007, Harry became the new Goblin and tried to kill Peter more than once. However, Harry got injured in the process and gained amnesia, as he temporarily forgot most of the things throughout his life, including his own father and the fact that Peter is Spider-Man, as well as the arrival of an alien from outer space known as the Venom, who ultimately corrupts and possesses Peter and brings out only the worst qualities out of him, as he becomes more vengeful, horrible, corrupt, and ultimately the revelation that the criminal that he chased 5 years ago was not the one who killed his uncle, but his partner, Flint Marko, also known as Sandman, who managed to escape from jail, and Peter managed to track him down and try to kill him more than once in order to avenge his uncle, as well as his own colleague, Eddie Brooke, who became possessed by the Venom and tried to kill Peter for seemingly ruining his life. However, now before I go any further, we all should stop and ask ourselves, is Peter Parker good? The reason why I'm asking this is simply because while it's undeniable that in the first and the second movie, the answer seems obvious. However, in the third movie, he seems to be more and more corrupted by his own dark side, as he lashed out at others, including MJ and even Harry. And even after Harry regained back his memories and tried to kill Peter again, he literally didn't have any problem to let him to die. However, Peter became fully aware that he remained corrupted by the Venom, and tried his best to get rid of it by using his greatest weakness, sound, and specifically loud noise. The ultimate resulted in him being depossessed by Venom, and in turn possessed Eddie Brock to become the new Venom instead. And ultimately, Peter feels complete remorse for all the things he has done. Not to mention that he ultimately forgives Sandman after he heard from him the truth about his uncle, and how he in fact killed him by accident and not by on purpose. And thus, not only letting Sandman to go, but finally made peace with his past, and as well as with Harry. And at the end of the day, the answer to the question is definitely yes. Peter Parker is a good person. He managed to save MJ, and he made peace with Harry, who in turn died trying to protect Peter. He managed to defeat Eddie Brock and Venom, and as I mentioned before, he forgives Sandman and let him go back to his daughter. And as such, Peter Parker started a new life, being married with MJ, having a family, but also likely continuing to be Spider-Man. However, this wasn't the last time we see this version of Peter Parker, as by 2024 in the MCU timeline, he appears in order to help his other two counterparts from the MCU and the Amazing Spider-Man film franchise respectively to defeat back their enemies and save them as well, including his first arch nemesis, the Green Goblin, before being eventually teleported back to his world, back to his friends and family. So in the end, who is Peter Parker? He's nothing more but an average man who got gifted with immense power, a power that he will use for the greater good in order to protect the innocents and punish the wicked. A man that could easily be called as one of the most iconic heroes in cinematic history. Thank you all for playing this new episode in today's analysis. I hope everyone enjoyed. Please don't forget to give a like and subscribe, everyone, and have a nice day.
Hey, kiddo!